Hey kids, Isaac here. Today's science video is brought to you by coprolite. Dinosaur poop that's been fossilized into rock. Pretty cool, huh? Okay, so this video, we are going to be talking about fossils and how the Earth changes and how scientists know about dinosaurs and what happened, how they piece things together. So, first, I would like to show you a few fossils just to talk about what a fossil is. So this here is a fish. Fishy? Okay, this is a fossilized fish from Wyoming. Now this fish, a long time ago, lived in a large lake, and eventually he died, sank to the bottom, was buried in sediments, and then became fossilized or turned to rock. So a fossil is something that once was living, or the sign of something that was living, like tracks. You know, tracks weren't really living. So it's something that was living, or the sign of that thing that has now turned to rock. That's a fossil, okay? This is a fish. Some more, these are some algae balls. We've got red-horned coral. You've heard of coral in the ocean, right? Yeah, this is called red-horned coral, and it's rock, okay? And then we've got the teeth from the ferocious mosasaur. This was a marine reptile, but they're ginormous and they have these humongous teeth. Okay, that is another fossil. So now we need to learn about fossils and why they're important. I mean, this is cool to hang on your wall, right? But does it really help scientists and people understand the history of the Earth? You bet it does. Okay, so I'm going to move all my stuff out of the way, all my props, and we're going to go on an adventure in a plastic tub. Okay, so we are going to talk today about the law of superposition. The law of superposition basically means that older things are lower on the layers, or is the lowest layer. And it doesn't make a lot of sense yet, maybe, but we'll get to that. Do not worry. So we're going to start with sand. Over time, what happens? Leaves fall to the ground, stuff dies, it breaks down, and on the ground, it begins accumulating, and it makes these layers, and it gets deeper and deeper and deeper, right? So those are layers, okay? So over time, we are going to start with sand. So this is, this sand is kind of wet, so ignore the wet sand, okay? So this is during a period of the Earth when it was a fairly dry, more like a desert kind of environment. Not a lot of water, so it's just sand, not a lot of organic material or anything. So there's not a lot of organisms buried in this sand. Okay, we're gonna throw one in there just for fun though. Let's take this guy. Let's pretend that he is a sand type dinosaur, right? It's a dry time, and so animals that die are animals that like dry conditions, right? Because that's what's living at the time. So along with the animals, and also we're gonna pretend like there's some plants. We're just gonna throw in these leaves, right? This leaf, plastic leaf. Okay, so now, in addition, this layer also traps all sorts of information, right? Like the wood, petrified wood like this, right? When trees fall over in the rings, scientists can learn a lot about what was going on right at the time of when this layer was accumulating, right? Law of superposition, the oldest layers are first. Okay, now we're going to talk about a change in the Earth when, for some reason, the Earth warmed up and it became a much wetter environment right here. right? So, now this is a slow change. It doesn't happen overnight, right? It takes a long time. We can't even observe, we can't even see the small changes, right? It may be a half degree for over several years or a full degree. It just takes a long time for these changes to happen, okay? So over time, it changed from this layer, which was dry, to a much more tropical environment. And so now I'm gonna use some potting soil. Okay, so remember, over time, it's accumulating and it's rising. So the newer layer is above the older layer. So here it goes. And we're filling in. It's getting deeper. I'm making a mess I'm gonna have to clean up. It's covering up the old layers. Okay, so now we've got this period in time. Okay, you see that? If you can see the layers, we've got a much lighter sandy layer, and then we've got a thicker layer, which is organic material. And during that time period, what happens? Well, just like anything, stuff dies. So here we have some animals that are more tropical type of animals, because that's the environment that they're in. Okay, so they die, and they get eventually covered up by the sediments and things that are accumulating over the top of them, and they get buried, and then they turn into rocks and fossils. So these are all really slow processes. Let's get to a new layer. We're gonna go with a volcano. So I've got some ash from my barbecue or from my fire pit, right? And so we're gonna pretend there's a great big volcano. So here comes the volcano. And when a volcano erupts, it sends ash all over. And it even covers the ground with a small layer of ash. So we are going to, this is really making a mess. Okay, so now we've got this really light, thin layer because it was a one-time volcanic event that exploded overnight, right? This is one of those quick, super fast processes. So we have this thin layer, and then we are going to have some more period of this nice tropical time. Okay, and we're gonna have another dinosaur die in there, and then all of a sudden we are gonna go to a cold, much more desert dry type environment. We're gonna go back to the sand. So here we have now layers, and if you can see the changing of layers. Now, as I said before, each layer is gonna trap things that scientists can study, like animals and plants, trees, like I said, with these, will give a lot of information, just what kind of animals and organisms they find in these layers tell a lot about the environment at that time. So this is how scientists piece together the history of the Earth, by looking at layers. Remember, the oldest layers are on the bottom, the youngest layers are at the top, the law of superposition, okay? And you can remember that fine layer of ash, it's thin, okay, covering up the ground. So that is how the history of the Earth is understood. Because then they can go back and they can date these different layers to find out how old they are. Now, I bet you really want to be a geologist or a paleontologist now, right? Really important and really fun digging up dinosaurs and then comparing the things that you dig up in one spot to the stuff you dig up in another spot. You can even match layers across the country and across the globe. This is how they figured out that the Earth used to have one big continent in the middle that eventually broke up and floated away, because they could match the layers of the rocks and the fossils on one continent and find the exact same layer on the other side on another continent with a huge ocean in between. That's how they know all these things, just by finding and documenting and analyzing the different layers. I hope you enjoyed our adventure through time today, talking about fossils and dinosaurs. When you're out on a family vacation, or maybe you live next to a mountain range, go look at the layers. Find a place where the earth has broken up and look at the different layers and identify them. It's pretty fun, and maybe you'll find a fossil or two. Just like I did when we found this fossil in Wyoming when we went to visit family. It's a great time, and kids will love it. So, have fun out there. This is Isaac saying so long.
This is the Zombie T-Rex. Subscribe to our channel if you dare for more fun science videos.
I already am subscribed. I'm not a zombie.